Rohan went to buy an Android mobile. The shopkeeper told him to pay 20% tax on list price if he asks for the bill. Rohan manages to get the discount of 5% on purchasing the mobile with a bill, and he paid the shopkeeper ₹8,550. Besides, he manages to avoid paying 20% tax on the listed price, but on the discounted price. What is the amount of discount he received in the overall transaction? What is the amount of discount that he has received in the overall transaction? So understand that this guy Rohan has went to buy a mobile phone. The shopkeeper told him to pay 20% tax on the list price if he asked for the bill. So if you want the bill, you have to pay 20% tax on the list price. Yeah. Now understand, let's assume the list price is L. Let's assume that the list price is equal to L. How much will you have to pay? What will be the total amount? Total amount will be L plus 20% of L, because he has to pay 20% tax, right? So this is what Rohan has to pay. L plus 20% of L, right? What did he do? Rohan managed to get a discount of 5% on purchasing the mobile bill, mobile with a bill. He managed to get a discount of 5%, right? He's got a discount of 5% on purchasing the mobile with a bill. And he paid the shopkeeper 8,550. So after taking the bill also, he has paid only 8,550. Besides, he managed to avoid paying 20% tax on the listed price, but on the discounted price. So he also ensures that he's paying 20% tax, but not on the listed price, on the discounted price. You're able to follow? He's paid 20% tax, but not on the list price. He's paid on the discounted price. What do you mean by discounted price? He's got a 5% discount, right? So he's paid 95% of the value, 95% of the listed value. And he has paid tax on that 95% of the listed value, right? Not on 100% of the listed value. What is the amount of discount he received in the overall transaction? What is the amount of discount that he has received in the overall transaction? So basically, in the real case, in the actual scenario, he has to pay L rupees, the list price, plus 20% tax on the list price. But he has got a discount of 5%. Discount of 5%. On what? On the list price. 5% on the list price. So basically, the total is made up of two components, L plus 20% of L, right? The price plus the tax. He has got 5% discount, which means he has to pay how much? Only 95% of list price. You're able to follow? I'm just explaining the concept. We are not dealing with numbers yet, right? So what happens? We can say that this 8,550 that he has paid, 8,550 is equal to what? 95% of the list price. Right, he has got 5% discount, right? 5% of the list price is discount. So he'll pay only 95%. Plus, he will pay 20% tax on this 95% of the list price. Actually, 20% tax is supposed to be paid on the list price only. But he manages to, you know, get a discount there also. He says, okay, I'll pay tax only on the discounted price and not on the listed price. So Rohan finally pays 95% of the mobile value and 20% tax on whatever that value comes out to be. This is equal to 8,550. So first and foremost, from this step, you have to get the value of L. Find out what is L. You're able to follow. Find what is L, and then you can simplify it further to get the required answer. He's asking us to find out the overall discount. Yeah. See, try to understand that I think 95 can cancel out 8,550, right? Check that. 9,500 minus 950 is 8,550. Yeah, I think it goes 90 times. So I'll do one thing to keep it simple. We can say this is like 95 by 100, right? 95 by 100. This is also 95 by 100. I'm removing the percentage. And 20% can be taken as 1 by 5. So overall, what happens? This becomes, if you take 95 by 100 common, 95 L by 100 common, we'll have 1 plus 1 by 5, which is 6 by 5. Yes or no? 95 L by 100. Here also 95 L by 100. 1 plus 1 by 5, which is 6 by 5. This is equal to 8,550. Now understand, 95 here goes how many times? 90 times. 95 goes 90 times. Right, and this goes 15 times. 15 into 5, 75 into 100, 7,500. So basically, list price is 7,500. Right, now if you take the real case, actual total, ideal total, not the actual total, but ideal total. Ideally, what should be the total amount? Ideally, what should be the total amount? The list price plus 20% of discount, 20% of tax. So the ideal total is equal to what? L plus 20% of L. So substitute this value of L here. What do we get? 7,500 plus 20% of 7,500, which comes out to be 20% of 7,500 is what? 1,500, right? So this comes out to be 9,000 rupees. Now understand, the actual total should have been 9,000. The ideal total should have been 9,000, but he's actually paid only 8,550. Yes or no? He has paid only 8,550. So how much discount did he get overall? He has got 450 rupees of discount. Yes or no? So discount, overall discount, overall discount is equal to, you don't have to write all the steps in the exam, I'm just trying to explain in detail. 9,000 minus 8,550, which is equal to 450 rupees. Again, remember, this looks to be lengthy because I have explained in detail. Sorry. Because I've given the whole explanation in detail, right? If you cut down the number of steps and the amount of explanation there, this would become a simple case, right? This will become a simple solution. The same thing can be solved using list prices 100 also, right? This is one way of solving it. Let me explain you the other method, right? I mean, you don't want to do this. This is the ideal solution. I mean, this is a conventional method where you have considered the value as L and you have solved accordingly. But the same thing can be done by assuming the list price is 100, right? So let me explain that also. Let me explain that solution as well. What happens? Let's assume that the list price is equal to 100. This is an assumption, right? So what should be the ideal total? In the ideal scenario, 100 rupees plus 20% tax, 120 rupees, right? This should be the ideal total. What happened? Rohan got a discount of 5%. Discount of 5% on 100 rupees, which is equal to 5 rupees. So actual total, how much did he pay? He paid 100 rupees minus 5 rupees plus 20% of 100 rupees minus 5 rupees. You understand? He got a 5 rupees discount on the list price. Also, he paid tax on the discounted price. So he paid 20% on 95 rupees, not on 100 rupees. So 95 plus 20% of 95. 20% of 95 is how much? 9.5 times 2, right? 19. So 95 plus 19, it comes out to be 114. You're able to follow? 114 rupees. Actually, he's supposed to pay 120. He has paid 114. Right? How much is he saving? 6 rupees is he saving. If you see in this transaction, 6 rupees is saving. 6 rupees is saving. Yes or no? How much did he save? He was supposed to pay 120. So overall discount, comes out to be what? 120 minus 114, which is equal to 6 rupees. But then understand that in our case, there is some other number given to us, right? 8,550. What is this 8,550? This 8,550 corresponds to 114. You understand? If the list price is 100, then what he pays is 114. But the list price is not 100, right? List price is something else. And for that something else, he has ended up paying 8,550. So I can say if 114 is equivalent to 8,550, we want what is the equivalent of 6 rupees. 6 rupees will be equivalent to what? Don't even find out the list price. By using this method, you don't even have to calculate what the list price is. That's not required, right? Overall, our final answer is what is the amount of discount that he received in the overall transaction. Amount of discount, if you take 100 rupees as the list price, is 6 rupees. But if the actual list price is considered, proportionately if you calculate, you will find out that 114 corresponds to 8,850. 6 corresponds to what? Cross multiply. Cross multiply and you will get the answer. So how much is this? 6 goes how many times here? 6 is like 19 times, right? So divide this by 19. You will get the answer. So question mark will be equal to 8550 into 6 by 114. How many times? 19 times. Now 855 divided by 19. How much is that? Hold on. What is wrong here? Yeah, we'll get 450, right? 450 is the answer. 8,550 divided by 90. See, 7,600 by 19 is 400. 950 by 19 is 50. I'm breaking it up. I'm breaking 8,550. I mean, I was doing split and merge, right? So 7,600 plus 950. 7,600 by 19 is 400. 950 by 19 is 50. 400 plus 50, 450. So option 3 is the answer. So if you find this to be a better method, go for it. Of course, this looks to be simple because we just have numbers. We don't have to use L or any other variable there. Yeah, so 100 rupees is the assumption. Based on that, the overall amount comes out to be 120 rupees because 20 rupees is the tax to be paid. But this fellow got a discount of 5%. Yeah, in fact, you need not do this also. I mean, if you see, he's got a discount of 5% on the list price. He's also got a discount of 5% on the tax. So overall discount is 5%. So directly I can say 5% saving on 120 rupees. So if you take 5% saving on 120 rupees, If you, you know, reduce this by 5%, 120 minus 5%. What is 5% of 120? 6 rupees. 120 minus 5% will directly give you 114 rupees. You don't even have to do this breakup. You know, that's one more level of smartness. You don't even have to, I mean, you can cut down one more step. Yes or no? But this detail step is required. Let's say if the discount is to be paid, if the tax is to be paid on list price, then that detail step is required.